South Dakota is facing demographic changes. These changes are impacting everything from businesses, healthcare, to agriculture, and even high school athletics. Despite how committed a community is to their hometown football team, declining enrollments and geographic challenges make it difficult, if not impossible, for some schools to sustain their athletic programs. Over the years, a few responses to these population shifts have included sharing services, creating a co-op, and even consolidating school districts.
In 2005, we co-opted all sports and started sharing administration at that time. And then in 10-11, we actually became one consolidated district of Bridgewater and Emery. The greatest change that I think has been really beneficial is that, you know, when we were separate, even before the co-oping times, everybody's scrambling for numbers. And so I think there were a lot of students doing things that weren't really their passion. One of the changes we really saw when we started co-oping and then consolidated is that kids didn't feel that need to go out for something that they no longer were interested in because numbers were better. And so it really started helping kids focus on some of their activities they're really passionate about.
The Ethan School District shares a football co-op with the Bridgewater-Emery program, but they are still separate school districts.
When I first got here 24 years ago, Bridgewater and Emery was a huge rivalry. It didn't matter what sport it was, football, basketball. They just got so much mutual respect for each other because of football that I think that rivalry has kind of gone by the wayside. I think the football co-op has really brought our communities together. There's no doubt, you go to a game any Friday night, you don't see a group of Ethan people over here and a group of Emery people over here and a group of Bridgewater people over here. You know, they're together. It's one united community as far as football goes, and you know, Friday nights are just a great thing for our three communities.
10-5, Jason Bailey is the superintendent at Bridgewater Emery. He recognizes the difficulty for any school district forced to consolidate.
I don't think any consolidations is easy, and I think you're going to have some resistance and it's going to be a battle. But if you can just look at the success of the students and the opportunities of your students, in the end, I really think you have to keep that in mind and not look at the selfish worrying about your town. You got to consider the best education you could possibly offer. Just coming off winning the state Class B basketball championship, and then in the same weekend our art group, we had the student with the best of show in Class B and overall third place in art. It's a joy to see the successes.
The relationship created between the Ethan Bridgewater Emery Seahawks football team has impressed many. These athletes will play as one on the football field, but oftentimes have to compete against each other in different sports.
It's a really hard game to watch, and it used to be a very hard game to coach. Those used to be your teammates, and now you're trying to compete against them. So, you know, the dynamics, I just see a lot of respect on the court between the kids. You know, they're always helping each other up. They still get after one another. They're still out there trying to win, but you just see a very mutual respect between the teams. The communities of Bridgewater, Emery, and Ethan, you know, they have high expectations of their kids. They want them to succeed. They want them to know what it's like to work hard and have to achieve something. So, you know, that just makes it real easy on us.
For Bridgewater Emery Ethan, this is their seventh title in nine appearances and their 6-9 AA title. They have won three of the last four championships.